हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ 9th लेक्चर ऑफ इमर्जिंग डोमेन इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग। आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर सुगंध गुप्ता एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर्स। इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट, दैट इज पार्ट 1 ऑफ लेक्चर 9, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द वर्किंग ऑफ फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर्स। वी हैव ऑल्सो कैलकुलेटेड द डीसी वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट वोल्टेज ऑफ रेक्टिफायर्स। इन टुडेज लेक्चर we will discuss and calculate the RMS value for the full wave rectifiers. Then we will see the efficiency of full wave rectifier. We will also calculate the peak inverse voltage of diodes in full wave rectifiers. And then we will calculate the ripple factor for the full wave rectifier. Now let us start with the RMS value of full wave rectifier. In the last lecture, we discussed the DC value of the output voltage. Today, we will calculate the RMS value of the output voltage for the full wave rectifiers. Now, for this, as we did in the case of half wave rectifier, we will first of all try to write down the formula. And the formula comes from the name itself, that is root mean square. So it is indicated as VRMS. Root mean square. Root square of the area that you calculated in the DC part also. And upon base. Base was, as you remember, it was pi. Because one cycle was from 0 to pi. So just remember the formula name. Recall the name root mean square and try to write down the formula. Now first of all, we will calculate V naught square d omega t integration 0 to pi. Let us calculate first of all this part, and it is given as, we already know that V naught is equals to Vi and Vi was equals to Vm sin omega t. So square gives us Vm square sin square omega t d omega t 0 to pi. Let us take out Vm square outside as it is a constant, and we are left with sin square omega t d omega t. Now if you want to integrate sin square x dx, then you replace sin square x by 1 minus cos 2x upon 2. So similarly we will do over here also, 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 and d omega t Vm square by 2 0 to pi d omega t minus cos 2 omega t d omega t 0 to pi. I hope everybody must have understood how I have opened this expression. Now Vm square by 2, it gives you only pi because omega t and from 0 to pi, or let me don't make a shortcut. Integration gives you omega t from 0 to pi minus sine 2 omega t by 2 from 0 to pi. Now Vm square by 2, this comes out to be pi minus 0, that is pi, and sine 2 pi is also 0 and sine 0 is also 0. So this whole part becomes 0. And you are left with Vm square by 2 into pi. So this is how we solved this much part. And now we will put it back into the formula. Vrms is equals to under root 1 upon pi, that is base. And we have already solved the integration of V naught square d omega t, which is Vm square pi by 2. Now answer comes out to be Vm by root 2. So Vrms for full wave rectifier is Vm by root 2. We need to remember this thing because by calculating the efficiency and the ripple factor, we will need this value again. And if you recall the half wave rectifier, the Vrms for half wave rectifier was Vm by 2. So similarly, you can also write the RMS value of the current, which is analogous to this part, that is Irms is equals to Im by root 2. So just remember the DC and the RMS value for both rectifiers, that is full wave and half wave rectifier. Now we have calculated the RMS value. Now let's move on to the next part, that is the efficiency of full wave rectifiers. Efficiency. So we always calculate efficiency in terms of percentage, and it is given by eta. You can write down percentage, and it is simply output upon input. So output is in the form of DC. So the formula is DC power, and through across what you have calculated the DC output, across load resistor. So DC power delivered to RL upon AC power that comes from secondary winding of the transformer. So AC power input from secondary. Here secondary means secondary winding. So DC power, when you are saying power, you need to write down I square R. I am writing the formula of power in terms of current and resistance. So DC power, so therefore IDC square RL upon, for AC you take RMS value, and input from secondary, so it is RS plus, we will also consider the resistance of diode, that is forward resistance, plus RL. So I have already told in the previous in the part of half wave rectifiers also, that RS and RF are so small that they could be neglected. So IDC square RL upon IRMS square RL. So you are left with this. So you know, remember the value of IDC for full wave rectifiers. It was 2Im by pi. So 2Im by pi whole square, RL, RL, consider this RL to be cancelled out, divided by IRMS square, that is Im by root 2 whole square. Now again simplifying it, 4Im square by pi square into 2 upon Im square. So it gives out, it gives you out 8 by pi square, and the efficiency comes out to be, just calculate it, the efficiency will comes out to be 81.2%. When you will multiply it with 100, it will come out to be 81.2%. So this is how we calculate the efficiency of full wave rectifier, and we get it. So just try to calculate it on your own and verify the answer. The efficiency for full wave rectifier comes out to be 81.2%. If you remember, the efficiency for half wave rectifier comes out to be 40.5%, and thus we can say that full wave rectifiers are more efficient as compared to half wave rectifiers. Now let us calculate the PIV, that is the peak inverse voltage of diodes in case of both full wave rectifiers, that is center tapped and bridge rectifiers. So peak inverse voltage, first of all recall the meaning of peak inverse voltage. Peak means maximum, inverse means reverse, and this is the maximum reverse voltage which a diode can tolerate during reverse bias before it gets breakdown. So therefore before it gets into the breakdown part. So let's calculate the value of PIV for both the rectifiers. Let us first of all see the PIV in case of center tapped rectifier. I'll roughly draw the diagram again for center tapped rectifier. And the diagram was like this. During, we will consider any of the cycles because one diode was reversed during each cycle. So I am considering the positive cycle where D1 was forward RL and D2 was reversed. So this is reversed, and VI was placed like this with the plus and minus, because this is the positive half cycle. And we will consider the voltage across this reverse bias diode as V. or you can say Vr. And we have to calculate this Vr. So how will we calculate it? We can simply, and what is the polarity of Vr? It is minus and plus, because this diode was placed in such a way that when it was reversed, it got minus sign on the p-type side and the positive sign on the n-type side. So this was the polarity of Vr. Now let us calculate this Vr. If we calculate it, we will get it by applying KVL. Apply it in any of the directions. Plus Vr minus Vi minus V naught is equals to 0. So this is this equation we get by applying KVL. And if you remember that Vi is equal to Vm sin omega t, and V naught is also equal to Vm sin omega t. So therefore, if I ask you that what is the maximum value of Vm sin omega t, so it is Vm. So here we have Vm and Vm. So Vr is equals to 2 Vm. So what we can say that the peak inverse voltage in case of center tapped rectifier of the diode is 2 Vm. So across each diode you will get the PIV as 2 Vm, whether you take D1 or whether you take D2. So this is the peak inverse voltage in case of center tapped, due to which the diodes of center tapped are costlier as compared to bridge type. So this is one of the advantages of bridge rectifiers, that it is cheap as compared to that of center tapped, because the diodes are costly as their PIV is high, that is 2 Vm. And also the secondary windings in the case of center tapped transformer is double as that of primary windings. So this is costlier. So center tapped rectifier is costlier. Now let us calculate the PIV in bridge rectifier. Again, I'll draw roughly a diagram, and I'll consider the positive cycle because some diodes were reversed during the positive cycle as well. So D1 was reversed. This was RL minus plus V naught, and this was forward. Again, this one was reversed. This one was forward. So we will calculate peak inverse voltage, means to calculate the voltage across a reverse bias diode. So here minus and plus, and this is Vr. Let's calculate it. So let's apply KVL in this upper triangle, from where you can get, and this is Vi, this is minus and for plus and minus for the positive cycle. So when I will apply this KVL in the upper triangle, I will get plus V naught minus Vr is equals to 0, and Vr equals to V naught, and you all know that V naught was equals to Vm sin omega t. That means the maximum value is Vm. So the peak inverse voltage in case of bridge rectifier is only Vm, and thus I was saying that the bridge rectifier is cheap as compared to that of center tapped rectifier. So these are the advantages of bridge rectifier over center tapped rectifier. Now so here we are done with the PIV part. Now let us see the another part, that is ripple factor of rectifiers, that is half wave and full wave rectifier. See, first of all we need to understand what is ripple. See, ripple, as the name itself sounds, that it is some type of disturbance in the output of rectifier. So what is a rectifier? Rectifier converts AC into DC, but none of the circuits is 100% efficient. So the output not only contains pure DC, in fact it also contains some components of AC. So that unwanted components of AC are called ripples. What are they called? They are called ripples. And ripple factor is the quantity which measures the amount of ripples. So more the ripple factor for any rectifier, lesser is the efficiency of the rectifier. So let's calculate, first of all derive the formula of ripple factor and then apply it to the half wave and full wave rectifiers. So let us see. So ripple factor is the ratio of AC component with respect to the DC component, because AC is the unwanted component. So ripple factor, denoted by small r, is equal to the AC component. And do we take the AC component directly? No, we take the RMS value of the AC component. And AC component of what? AC component of output voltage or of output upon DC component of output. So we shall represent the formula as V RMS value of AC upon VDC. Now we have calculated the values of VDC and VRMS for half and full wave rectifier, but we haven't calculated the RMS value of the AC component of the half and full wave rectifier. So we need to derive a formula for it. And how do we derive? We will start from the RMS value, that is root mean square, and it is given by the under root of the square of under root of the sum of the squares of both the components. So we DC component and AC component, but the AC component is not taken directly, RMS value is taken. So this is this. Now if I squaring on both sides, I get this, and if I calculate or if I divide both the sides by VDC square, dividing both sides by VDC square. Why we are doing so? Because we have to calculate this formula. So VRMS upon VDC whole square 1, because VDC square by VDC square 1, plus VAC square RMS upon VDC square. So what is this? This is the ripple factor. So but the square of ripple factor. So VRMS upon VDC whole square minus 1 under root is equals to ripple factor. So the formula for ripple factor is, you have to remember, VRMS upon VDC whole square minus 1. This is the general formula for ripple factor, and from here we will calculate the ripple factors for half and full wave rectifiers. Let us calculate for half wave rectifier first of all. For half wave rectifier, VRMS is equals to, yes, I hope you all remember, Vm by 2, and VDC was Vm by pi. So on putting these values, R is equals to Vm by 2 whole square divided by Vm by pi whole square minus 1, you will get answer as 1.21. Just verify your answer by calculating it on your own. And if when you will calculate the ripple factor for full wave rectifier, again you will just recall that VRMS for full wave rectifier was Vm by root 2, VDC for full wave rectifier was 2 Vm by pi. And when you will put this both the values in the formula of ripple factor, you will get answer as 0.48. just verify it. So the ripple factor for full wave rectifier is 0.48, and as we have already told that more the ripple factor, lesser will be the efficiency. So that is what we have already learned, that the efficiency of half wave rectifier was less because the ripple factor was more for a half wave rectifier, and the efficiency of full wave rectifier is high because the ripple factor is less for the case of full wave rectifier. So this is what about the ripple factors for the rectifiers. I hope you must have understood the derivations, and just recall the values of VRMS and VDC for rectifiers. Have a nice time. Good day.